you are taking up time and chances from people that are serious about buying a house.
Why do I want to be? Today I'm in my gorgeous new listing.
Hey guys, it's Natasha with soulbynet.com.
Okay, so I stopped out, got a pamphlet. 2 and 3 story townhomes.
I'll double check the MLS.
We're not family. So in life, celebrate the small things. Take some time to celebrate yourself.
Do you see that? Look at the windows. We're in Atlanta, Georgia.
Hi, it's Natasha with soulbynet.com, associate broker with Virtual Properties Realty in Georgia.
Today, you guys are getting a rant. A rant, a PSA. It's gonna be more of a PSA for fickle buyers. Listen, this market is too crazy. Inventory is too low. There are too many buyers, more buyers than there are homes for sale. Like, if you're in the market looking for a house and you aren't sure or serious, like, don't do it. Stay out of the market. Like, you are taking up time and chances from people that are serious about buying a house. Why do I say that? Glad you asked. Have a listing. We got over 20 offers. And side note, like a video a couple months ago, I'm like, man, these buyers are wearing me out. I need to get listings. Agents, listings are work just as well. It's just a different type of work. So back to the story. So 20 plus offers, go through all the work in the process, listing the home, getting all these offers, getting all these calls, emails, texts, agents not reading, going through all of that. Put this spreadsheet together to review all the information with the sellers. The sellers spend their time going through the offers, decide on an offer. The buyer's agent, it's, you know, vouching for her buyer. The buyer looks strong. This buyer's not serious. This buyer is not ready. This buyer is fickle. This buyer is playing around. Even the buyer's agent was like, I'm firing him. Like, no, because he's wasting her time. Come to find out, well, he's about to terminate on this contract. Got the inspection report. And he's like, you know, just making little mountains out of molehills. Won't even allow the agent to advise him to submit the amendment to address concerns, which my sellers are open to. They've lived in the house. They've taken care of the house. These aren't even big things, y'all. Like, but when buyers are not serious, when buyers don't listen, when buyers listen to other people, when buyers are fickle, they just go places in their head. Like, you just cannot talk them down. Agents, you just cannot talk them down. It is the most frustrating thing in the world because agents work so hard showing all these darn properties in this market, doing all the work that is required. You finally, after losing out on homes, you know, you would think the buyer would get it. Like, you finally, you got one under contract. You got a good one under contract. The agent is saying how this fits all of his needs. This is the perfect home for him. But now he's gone. He done mentally said, no, we just need to terminate. Granted, he has stresses in life that he's going through, but people, this is life. This is life. Like, show me somebody that does not have stresses that they're going through. I can show you several clients that have closed on homes, bought homes, built homes that have dealt with stresses. Stresses. I have had people that have lost loved ones during the home buying process. You think they called me and was like, oh, we need to cancel the contract. Like, and I get people handle things differently, but back to my point, my PSA, my rant, buyers, like, if you're not serious, like, please don't come in this market buying up time, taking up time from buyers that are truly serious and truly need a home. And agents, I want to say, like, vet your clients as best as you can. Spoke to this agent. There were some red flags for her, but she thought she worked through some of those. with this being the second home that he terminated, she probably felt like, okay, the first one had its reasons, but this one is gonna be the one. If she continues to work with him after this one, what's the saying? What's the saying? I don't know the official saying, but I know the saying from the J. Cole song, shame on, fool me once, shame on me, fool me twice, you won't fool me again. Something like that. So, no. Some of these buyers, like, there are buyers that are serious, committed. Oh my gosh, I have so many of them. Just love them. Love them, wish I can clone them. But I have come across others where, yeah, that could be a whole nother video. So, yeah. I'm gonna sign out here. Any questions, any comments, you can leave them down below. Like, woo! So what do I have to do now? I'm about to go call these other offers to see, hey, have y'all found a house? Are you guys still interested? So when I tell my sellers, I wanna have a backup option for them so they don't get turned off. Hence why backup offers are good. Hence why staying in good communication when you're told that your offer wasn't accepted is a good thing, because things like this does happen in this world of real estate. Y'all, trust and believe, and I've said this for years now, like, I don't know how many more years I got in real estate or in this level of real estate right here. There's so many other things you can do in real estate, but this direct people communication aspect of it, like, it is mentally taxing, physically, emotionally, like, this right here. Yeah, I don't know how many more years you got your girl, but yeah, we gonna keep it pushing. We're gonna keep it pushing. This is real estate. Things happen. I don't guarantee a smooth process because it is real estate. What I do guarantee is that when something comes up, if you stick in there with me, I will navigate you to the closing table. So let me get out. I'm about to hop into Starbucks because I was headed to Georgia to go ahead and check out a new construction property for a buyer. Yeah, I'm gonna need to stop here and work on this before I head out there. So thank you guys for watching. Have a positive, peaceful, and productive day. Bye. Oh, I forgot to mention another thing about this buyer and why this agent, she really needs to fire him, is because he's already sending her other houses to go and look at. Like, you won't even allow her to do the job. You won't even allow the process of real estate to work. So you just want to go on to the next property, probably get property number 3 under contract and do the same thing again. Like, nobody had time for that. Who has time for that? No, nobody has time for that. Fool me one time, shame on you. Fool me twice, can't put the blame on you.